How could this and this lead to this?
With a little something called nanomagnetometry.
This is the Qubit Lab.
Sensing magnetic fields is of crucial importance for numerous applications, ranging from material science to biomedical imaging.
Perhaps one of the most widely known uses is magnetic resonance imaging, or MRI. MRI is an indispensable tool for evaluating biological tissue. It works by detecting magnetism originating from protons within our body. Every proton is a tiny little magnet called a spin, and in order to detect the magnetism in MRIs, currently it requires many spins. We're talking 10 to the 15th power. That magnitude of spins causes a spatial resolution in the order of a few millimeters.
Think of reading magnetism as an analogy for examining a photograph, such as this adorable one of Gabe. When you blow up the photograph to look at the detail, you can see the pixelation. This is similar to current MRI techniques.
Since MRI requires this many spins to measure, the amount of time it takes results in a less detailed image, kind of like the pixelated photo.
But a group of scientists in Stuttgart, Germany are working on a way to detect magnetism with far fewer spins. Creating an image in less time would result in a much higher resolution. In other words, we'd be able to see a lot more detail in the photograph.
The scientists used an atomic magnetometer and a diamond with what's called an NV defect center to make it happen. The NV center is basically a missing atom within the diamond. This hole can only be filled by electrons from surrounding atoms, in this case, a nitrogen atom.
It gives off a pink fluorescence, which is why some gemstone diamonds are pink. By carefully measuring the fluorescence of a center, scientists can measure its energy levels. And the energy levels shift when the center feels a magnetic field. This makes the NV center the smallest sensor known today. So small that it can detect the magnetic field of a single spin.
Creating a medical scanner from these sensors would dramatically improve the resolution of our MRI scans, down to the nanoscale. We could zoom in and see magnetic fields of single cells, such as neurons in the brain. We might even be able to do MRI on single molecules.
Once doctors could examine a human organism at that level of detail, the understanding of physiology would be greatly improved, allowing them to examine the molecular process of any disease, including cancer.
That's it for us. I'm Gabe.
And I'm Laura.
We'll see you next time.
Okay, Gabe, for the MRI to work, you're going to have to stay very still.
Okay, can do.
Great, I'll let you know when you can move. It might take a few minutes.
Hello? Laura? I'm gonna assume this is all part of the MRI.